Welcome back to the Talos Principle. Do you know what time it is? It's time for Easter eggs. I mentioned in the last episode that the only thing really left for me to do with this game is just look for any alternative endings that I missed, and look up missed Easter eggs. So the first thing I did was look up any alternative endings, and it turns out I actually experienced all of them. So there's three endings. There's the main ending, kind of the easiest one, where you just go with Elohim. And then there's the slightly harder one, where you actually ascend the tower. And then there's the third and hardest one, where you get all of the stars, and become immortal, become a messenger. And that's it. So the only thing left to do is just find the missed Easter eggs, and this is one of them. It is a literal Easter egg, and this is inside of A4. Which, if you don't remember this place, let me just refresh your memory, let me kill myself here. That is this place. So there's three Easter eggs to this place, two of which I found, the third one, the egg, I did not. So I also got the floppy disk, if you remember, from right up there. The one with the kitten pictures. And there's also the walkie-talkie somewhere over there. And then there's the egg. Okay, let's go find some more. Before I go any further, I should probably give credit for where I'm actually getting this information from. So all of this is coming from a Steam guide made by CPC Algent. So this next one is in A2. There's two Easter eggs that I missed here. And both of them are messages in bottles. So, here's one. Ah, of course it's cursive writing. Oh my god. Okay, can I read it? Next to a pond, frog, kind of? The frog, please kill me, kiss me? Is that saying kiss me or kill me? I don't know. You can read this on your own if you want to. If you want to, pause the video right now. Okay, let's continue to the other one. I can actually throw the bottle. Ooh, look at that. Try to read it. Try to read it. Good luck. Alright, the other message in the bottle is over here. You know, if you're gonna put a message in a bottle, I really don't think you should write in cursive, because there's a pretty good chance that the message is gonna kinda like fade and get smudged and stuff, and you really don't want cursive to smudge. Hey, more cursive! Wonderful. Alright, once again, pause right here if you want to read it. Okay. Let's, move on to the next thing. Here's a missed Easter egg in A7. There's a very faint SOS signal that's been kind of scratched into the sand. I suppose scratched is probably not the right word. I feel like I maybe already found this. I'm not quite sure. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. I really can't remember. Okay, on to the next one. Here's a missed one in B3. That's this place, the one where I found that weird, kind of twisting, messed up hallway in one of the shadows. So I found that one, but there's one more that I missed, and that is Pac-Man. Hello! It's so happy. Do you think it would eat me if I put my foot in its mouth? Let's not try it. Ooh, this one should be fun. So this is B6. Remember this really weird place that I came to? It only had a couple puzzles, and a lot of them didn't require many tools, and it seemed like it was very barren, right? I couldn't find a single Easter egg here at all. Well, it turns out there actually is one. And you get to it from a jumping puzzle. So check this out. I haven't quite done the full thing, but I jump part of the way up and it seems to work. Jump from there onto the statue, and then fall off. That's not part of the plan. And then we jump onto the side of the wall here. And then apparently just keep climbing up. Secrets. This is supposed to be Sam's room. He's got self-portraits of him looking like a badass. Of course he does. All his wonderful implements of death and destruction. Wait, can I actually play? Oh, I would love it if I can. Kanoom. Kamikaze. Why is it missing? Clear. Werebull. That was actually an enemy type in one of the Serious Sam games, a werebull. I can turn it on! I'm pretty sure you would never want to play a shooter with a setup like this. What is that? ZX Spect Run? I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be a Spectrum. I still don't know what that is, though. Load new commander. This ain't no Serious Sam. What the hell is this? Can I actually type Y? No? Does it not do anything? I don't think it does. Can't click it, can't type Y while looking at it, can't do anything with that. I think that's it. Also, I can entirely clip through the couch. I don't think there's anything else out here, at least according to the guide, but let's just take a quick look around. That music is awfully persistent. Okay, that's it. I missed one Easter egg in B7. So right over this dune is a bunch of just body parts strewn about. Some serious carnage happened here. It seems I only found 2 out of the 5 Easter eggs in C3. And this is the place with the jetpack, in case you don't remember it. So here's one of them.
Fly, you fools!
Poor thing. Alright, let me see if I can go find the others. Oh, apparently the next Easter egg is actually just right next to the first one. Apparently it's somewhere down here. Oh, crap. No, what happened to you, Sirius? You seem to have found yourself in a serious predicament. Oh! I guess that's to prevent you from having to kill yourself if you happen to find yourself down there. That's actually very considerate. Okay, there's one more. The last Easter egg for this place seems pretty involved. So it requires you to have the jetpack, and if you use the jetpack to go under the entrance to this puzzle here, there is this secret place. Whoa. Okay, calm down. I really don't want to die because then I'll have to redo everything I just did. So there's this little secret entrance, and the puzzle guide calls it the Frozen Gnar Cave. So I guess it's some sort of a beast's lair. Anyway, it's rather well protected. And according to the guide, you need 3 jammers, 2 boxes, 1 fan, 1 connector, and a red laser from another puzzle. So I believe I have everything set up. I just gathered all those pieces. 2 boxes, 1 connector, 1 fan, 3 jammers, and the red power source from another puzzle is right there. So, let's do this. Okay. Now it's actually safe to walk here. Is the red power for opening this up, or would that be what the jammer's for? I'm not sure. Let's try the red power first and see what happens. It might be for powering the fan. Yeah, it's for the fan. I see, I need to power the fan and then put a box there and actually keep this closed. Gotcha. Okay, it says I need another box, so I suppose I should go grab it, but I'm not sure what it's for yet. It's so dark. Ooh, pretty. It's an ice cave. Well, this is the frozen Gnar cave, I suppose that's a Gnar. Can I unfreeze it? Anything around here? Oh my god, the lighting in this place is really funky. Where's that light even coming from? It does say, three jammers, check. Two boxes, check. One fan, one connector, and a red laser. So what is the second box for? As far as I can tell, I only need the one box. Can I melt it with the exhaust of my jetpack? Burn! Burn! Nope. I guess that's it. Not to take away from how cool this puzzle is, I just expected there to be a little bit more because of what the guide said, but this is actually really cool. Disappointed I didn't get to use this box, though. Onwards and upwards to the next one. Well, that seems to be the end of the Easter eggs that I missed that are at least mentioned in the guide itself, but I did find, I found at least three more that were actually mentioned in the comments of the guide, but weren't in the guide itself. And it's funny, quite a few of them I was so close to finding them, but I just missed them. So one of them is up here. There is actually an Easter egg up here. Remember the crazy hijinks that I did to actually get up here? So there is actually something up here. Need to take this box with me, and I think it might be too far. Yeah, it's too far gone. Alright, I gotta move these back up. Come on. You know you want to come with me. Oh, for the love of God. I can't jump on it. There we go. Okay. So apparently, if you go over here, what I missed, see, this is where I went before. But if you get over there, there's something. I think how you do it is by jumping up here. No, this is not a good position. There we go, that should do it. Aha! There we go. Little note scribbled in the stone here. What's this say, like, star, star... Are you enjoying the... I don't know what that says. Enjoying the... something... of EL. Now, apparently this is a reference to some anime. I have no idea what anime, though. But apparently it is. I don't think there's anything more up here, but let me just take a quick look around. And I fell off. Okay, I think we're done here. I also missed one that you can access from level 3 of the tower. I think this is another one that I just narrowly missed. So apparently if you go down here... I'm trying to remember if I was ever actually up here. I probably did get here at some point. I think I jumped on pretty much everything that you can around the tower. And then if you jump over here... Oh, I missed. Just barely made it. Alright, apparently if you do this and then just kind of inch your way around the side... There we go. And apparently this is a reference to The Mentalist. There's a very small and very strange Easter egg in this place. So remember this absolutely hellish puzzle in the tower? The one that took me like a half hour to solve and many, many retries? Well, it turns out there's something strange with one of these force fields up here. Actually, not one of the force fields, but one of these, whatever you call them. So, you know how if you try to take an item through one of these, normally it just makes like a rejected kind of sound? Because it automatically takes the item out of your hand and just puts it on the ground so you can't transfer items through it? Well, apparently there's something very special about this particular one. For some strange reason, if you try to take any item through it, it makes a weird noise. Yeah, I have no idea. The very last Easter egg to check out is on top of the tower. So remember this kind of crazy mess of pipes? Apparently there's something actually up here. I'm not entirely sure where it actually is up here. I think it's the other way. Yeah, it's the other way. Here we go. Pipeline 1.048596. And apparently this is also another reference to an anime. Okay, I think that's it. Yeah, so I'd estimate that, on my own, I found probably like 60 to 75% of the Easter eggs, probably closer to 60. And I've just checked out every single one from the list in that guide, and also three or four more from the comments of the guide. Most likely there's at least a couple more that I've missed, and perhaps even a couple that no one has actually found yet. That is very possible. But without a doubt, this is the vast, vast majority of them, so I feel pretty satisfied. So that is all three endings down, all stars gotten, all known Easter eggs. I think that's it. I really can't think of anything else left to explore. Yeah, so I'm trying to think, do I want to make a thoughts kind of review type video for this game? I played it for so long, I feel like I have to. And I want to, it's just that I'm always really bad at doing them, to be honest. They make me nervous and... ooh, this is actually kind of fun. doing them makes me nervous. And I always feel like, no matter what I feel about a game, if I make a review type video, my thoughts don't come out nearly as well as they kind of were in my brain. It's really frustrating when you really like something, and you can't quite explain why. But I did play this game for like 45 hours, and I got pretty damn deep into it. I mean, I found all the stars, completely on my own. I translated almost every single QR code, or no, not QR codes, actually I did translate almost every single QR code, but I meant translating the hexadecimal to text. I think I found every sound time capsule. Yeah, I got pretty damn deep into this game. So, I'm probably gonna make a review type video of some sort. My overall impressions of this game are probably pretty obvious at this point, but it's damn enjoyable. Really, really enjoyable. Very smart, I love the atmosphere of it, the story. I really, really love the story. Which is not something typical for me when it comes to puzzle games. Typically, the story just feels kind of extra and put on top. And not really an integral part of the story, but in this case, an integral part of the game, but in this case, it absolutely is. The story is very closely tied to the puzzles that you do. Which is very cool. That's usually one of my biggest problems with puzzle games, is kind of a sense of pointlessness to everything. You know, there's puzzles, and maybe the puzzles are good on their own, but why am I even solving them in the first place? And any story, if it even exists, is usually very flimsy. But in this case, it's a really well-developed world. And I just love AI. Artificial intelligences and questions of... can AI actually become advanced enough to be alive? And things like that. It's just very cool. Really, the only major complaint with this game that I have, for the most part, is just that in the later stages, I feel like the puzzles themselves feel kind of... not pointless, but they just... they feel kind of repetitive. And I found that solving the puzzles was not all that interesting on their own. I was more interested in breaking the puzzles, or finding Easter eggs or something like that, rather than actually solving the puzzles themselves. And I think that's because, at least in the later stages, for the most part, they don't really introduce any new kind of tools or any kind of new sorts of thinking. But for the most part, it's just throwing more things at your face. You know, before there was a puzzle that just used a jammer, or a puzzle that just used a connector, and now here's a puzzle that uses a connector, a jammer, three boxes, oh, and it's in a maze! And there's miniguns. Like, it's just kind of throwing more stuff into this big, kind of messy thing, and that's not particularly interesting to me. Because in the end, after solving it, I realize it's just basically the same thing I did before, but just kind of more of these things together. But aside from that, it was just really damn good. So, I just want to say, anybody who's joined me along for the ride, all 45 plus hours of it. Through, I think, over 100 puzzles, yeah. And finding all the stars. Finding all these Easter eggs and just ramming my head against every single...
Please, listen to me. Yes, the tower leads out of this world. It leads to freedom and truth. But it also leads to the end of us.
Yeah, anyone who's joined me for all of my explorations, banging my head against walls and banging my head against anything that looks vaguely door-like to see whether it's actually solid, to try to find secrets and stuff like that, thank you for joining me. It was a hell of a lot of fun, and I hope you enjoyed. Shall we jump?
To glory and beyond into death.